Hi, I'm Juliana Hudson, and this is a PNI Minute. Ketamine-assisted psychotherapy has really been focused on depression, treatment-resistant depression, major depressive disorder, and these are the things that we see ketamine have a really quick antidepressant effect for. We are learning that ketamine can work for a lot of different mental health struggles. So often people come in also with anxiety or with anxiety as their main diagnosis. We have people coming in with alcohol use disorder. There has been more evidence that ketamine-assisted psychotherapy can also be really effective for alcohol use disorder, and I think this is going to be an exciting area of research in the future. We've also worked with people with extensive trauma histories, and ketamine can be really helpful for that as well. But really, the diagnosis that seems to have the most traction right now is depression. Within the therapeutic aspect, there's an intake process where first the therapist and the patient meet to really see if it's a good fit. The therapeutic relationship is really essential in this approach. After we see that it is a good psychological fit, then we make sure that it's a good therapeutic fit. And after the intake, we do a prep session in which we go through all of the logistics of what it's going to look like. So big part of the psychotherapy aspect of this medicine treatment is set and setting. So set is the mindset that you come in with, and we take this aspect very seriously, and really to just make sure that the environment is as serene and calm as possible with as little stimulus as possible, because we really want this to be an internal experience for people. We really want this to be a process where people are engaging with their psyche and engaging with their consciousness in a way that is not distracted by anything outside of that. The therapist is sitting with the client in the room the entire dosing session, which is not usually what happens with ketamine infusions. The client knows that no matter what, they have somebody there that they can reach for if they start to feel overwhelmed. The acute period usually lasts for about 30 to 45 minutes, and sometimes patients want to continue to rest after that and just let the experience kind of unfold and let them process it and sit with it. And others, by 45 minutes, really just want to pop up and talk about what they've experienced and process it a little bit. Within this aspect, the therapist really just serves as holding the container. Within the process of ketamine-assisted psychotherapy, we tend to recommend 6 dosing sessions, 1 session a week for 6 weeks. And with that, after every dosing session within the same week, we have an integration session. Essentially, it looks like a regular therapy session, but we're really going in on what came up in the journey, what came up afterwards, because that period after is also really essential for the unfolding and the insights and things coming up. And it is also the period after, around 48 hours, that the brain has the most neuroplasticity. So this is the time that we really want to use to integrate positive behavior and new frameworks and insights. So there is a bigger possibility of making those neural connections in the brain for longer lasting success. So in that integration session, we're really taking what came up after, and how can that be applied to your life? How can we use those insights and move out of depression or move out of whatever mental health struggle that we're struggling with? So in these experiences, people can often have mystical experiences, unitive experiences, revisiting childhood memories, important friendships, important relationships, and that can be a really awesome experience just within itself, and a cool, healing, pleasurable experience to look back on. But without intentional integration, it's really difficult to actually make this experience mean something long term. So the integration aspect of ketamine-assisted psychotherapy is really about what came up in the session or what came up after, and how do we move that from in our minds and in our hearts to actually integrating it into our lives. So we've seen in our patients that 6 sessions tend to offer longer benefits. So after session 1, you know, people start to open a little bit, but may not feel like a really drastic change. And then by session 3 or 4, we tend to start to see a bigger shift. And after 6, it really seems like stacking those can really help have a longer lasting effect. But also ongoing therapy is really helpful because these medicines can hit on a really deep unconscious level. We know that healing is not a linear process. So really having a container and having support to move through whatever, you know, pitfalls come up is really helpful for sustained success of this treatment.